So earlier I had talked about how you should not use conservation of mechanical energy principle in the case of an impact unless the impact is given to you as a perfectly elastic impact. So a perfectly elastic impact is characterized by coefficient restitution B, 1, right? So this is perfectly elastic collision or impact. Okay, so now the question is, if we have a loss in mechanical energy, why is that? And why is it that for a perfectly elastic collision, we don't have any loss in mechanical energy? Okay, so let's look at what happens when E is actually equal to 1. So when E is equal to 1, by definition, E is minus VB plus minus VA plus relative velocity of separation over VB minus minus VA minus, that's relative velocity of approach. So for a perfectly elastic collision, this is equal to 1. So we get VB plus minus VA plus equal to VA minus minus VB minus, right? So what we'll do is we'll bring A terms on the same side. So we get VA minus plus VA plus equal to VB plus plus VB minus, right? That's what we get from equal to 1. We also know that for the impact between the two particles on a frictionless surface, the momentum is conserved. So we have MA VA minus plus MB VB minus equal to MA VA plus plus MB VB plus, right? So I'm going to rearrange this. So I'm going to bring all the A terms on the same side. So I get this equal to MB minus VB minus. Okay, now it looks like, you know, this equation over here and this equation, you know, there's something we can do, you know, with both of them. So what we'll do is we'll actually multiply these two. So all the left-hand side terms will get multiplied and all the right-hand side will get multiplied and we'll have an equal to sign. So, you know, we'll do this is 1, this is 2. So 1 times 2 gives us, we get MA times VA minus square minus VA plus square, okay, equal to MB VB plus square minus VB minus square, right? Okay, and I'm going to add 1/2 in the front of both of these, and I will now bring the pre-impact velocity terms on one side and the post-impact velocity terms on the other side, and I get 1/2 MA VA minus square, and I get plus 1/2 MB VB minus square equal to 1/2 MA VA minus square plus 1/2 MB, sorry, this is plus VB plus square, right? Now let's look at this. What is this? This is nothing but the kinetic energy of the system, right? 1/2 MV square is the energy, kinetic energy of one particle, and this is the kinetic energy of the system before the impact. So this is kinetic energy of the system before impact. And this is kinetic energy of the system after impact, right? Assuming that the particles are not going up and down, so there's no other factor, there's no other force of gravity or anything like that. The only energy in the system is due to the kinetic energy of the particles. Then you can clearly see that the kinetic energy before the system and after the system is actually conserved. Now, you wouldn't opt in this relationship unless E was equal to 1. Okay, so this would not happen unless E was equal to 1. So if E is not equal to 1, if the question doesn't say that E is 1 or it's a perfectly elastic collision, please do not use conservation of mechanical energy principle. It's a very commonly made mistake by the students where they, you know, equate the mechanics of the system before impact with the after impact without paying any attention to what kind of collision it is. Okay, so if E is not equal to 1, so if E is not equal to 1, which will be the case for an elastic collision where E could be between 0 to 1 or E could be actually 0 in extreme, then there is a percentage loss. So percentage loss in kinetic energy would be equal to whatever the total initial kinetic energy was minus the final kinetic energy divided by the initial one, and you can multiply it by 100 to get a percentage loss in kinetic energy. Okay, so if E is close to 1, you know, something like, let's say E is equal to, I don't know, 0.9, then you might see there is a less loss in kinetic energy versus there would be if E was smaller than 0.9, let's say U is equal to 0.5. So this could give rise to another kind of conceptual question where I might say that there is one collision which is perfectly elastic, you know, where E is 1, or it is, you know, close to being perfectly elastic, like 0.9, versus another collision where E is equal to 0.1, which one would suffer from more loss in kinetic energy, right? And the answer to that question is, you know, fairly simple in this case now, because if E is equal to, you know, close to 1, if E is close to 1, then you'll have less loss in kinetic energy. All right, so let's do an example now. All right, it's a numerical example. This is example, you know, 5.5 from the textbook. So we have a bowling ball, okay? So the bowling ball A, right? So this is a platform, you know, we have the separation, and we have A over here. The bowling ball A is moving with velocity VA minus, and it arrives at a return station and collides with ball B. So there's another ball B, which is at rest. So VB minus actually is zero, okay? So V minus zero. Ball A and B have weights, weight W equal to 13 pound and WB equal to 16 pound. So VA minus is given as 6 feet per second. WA is 13 pound, WB is 16 pound, okay? They have identical diameters and the coefficient restitution for the collision is equal to 0.98. So E is 0.98. So you can see that E is very close to 1. So we shouldn't see much loss of kinetic energy in this case. Determine the post-impact velocity of the balls A and B. So A is of course going to collide with B because B is at rest, and we have to find VA plus and VB plus. Okay? So you draw the free body diagram at the time of impact. At the time of impact, there is no external force acting on the system if you neglect the friction, which means that the momentum is going to be conserved. So let's write that. So MAVA minus plus MBVB minus is equal to MAVA plus plus MBVB plus. This is the direct central impact. The only velocities are along one direction. You know, we can say this is X direction, okay? So this is zero because VB minus is zero, and VA plus and VB plus are our unknown. So that's one equation. Of course, it's not going to solve the problem for us because we have two unknowns. So we'll write the E equation. So E is minus VB plus minus VA plus over VB minus minus VA minus, okay? And now if you substitute for, you know, everything in here, all the given values, you will find VB plus to be equal to 5.32, 6 feet per second, and VA plus is minus 0.5545 feet per second, okay? What this is saying is that after the impact, A is actually going to be moving in the opposite direction while B is going to be moving towards the right-hand side. And if you compute the percentage loss in kinetic energy, so percent delta T, let me say percent delta T, it comes out to close to 2.185%, right? Which is, you know, not zero because it's not a perfectly elastic collision, but it is close to being zero,